coming for the next part of that our revision chapter. In our past video, I had discussed up to that that two resistance connected in parallel, that part. So number 4 question. According to international rules of color, the insulation of earthware, international color law we know. So what will be the earthware color? Options are red, blue, green, brown. Remember, according to the international concept, earthware always will be green. Earthware, no matter what, earthware always will be green. So option will be C, green. Option C, option will be C, green. Next one, if 4 2 ohm resistance connected in parallel combinations, the equivalent resistance are 4 2 ohm resistance means like this, they are connected 2 ohm here, then 2 ohm, so 4 2 ohm resistance are connected in parallel. What will be the equivalent resistance? We know that this is question number 5. So we know that R equivalent 1 by R will be equal to 1 by 2 4 resistance are connected in parallel, all have same value in the denominator part, so it will be 1 2 3 4 4 by 2, that is 2 ohm. So R equal to 1 by 2 ohm. Options given are 4 ohm, 2 ohm, 1 ohm, 1 by 2 ohm. So 1 by 2 ohm is my answer. So for the question number 5, option will be 1 by 2 ohm means D. D. Option will be D. So copy down this solution with the respective diagram. In your classwork copy I will check. Next one, working principle of Barlow's wheel depend on. Barlow's wheel we know, that is, there is a strong magnetic field. Within that strong magnetic field, there is a current carrying conductor. Now if there is a current carrying conductor, so that current carrying conductor and the magnetic field, both will have the effect on one another and the wheel will start rotating. We know Barlow's wheel very well. Achha. Working principle of Barlow's wheel depends on, options are Fleming's right hand rule, Fleming's left hand rule, right hand thumb rules, Ampere's swimming rule. What will be the option? Obviously Fleming's left hand rule. So option will be B. So question number 6, option will be B. Question number 6, option will be B. Next, question number 7, I am going for question number 7. Copy down, this will be option number B. Achha, question number 7. If current through a conductor is twice of its initial value, if current through a conductor is twice of its initial value, then the heat produced by the current carrying conductor will be, means here I am having a current carrying conductor, so I is flowing through it, so this is my initial value conductor, this is initial value. Now second time, instead of I, 2I passes through the same conductor, first half I is passes through conductor, second half 2I passes through the conductor, then the heat produced, see current is changing. Current is changing. There is no data regarding potential difference and the resistance will not change. That much knowledge we are having. Resistance will not change. Now, suppose current has been changed. So, current has been changed means potential has been changed. Clear? So, let's go for that. So, first half it will be I square RT. So, H1 equal to I square RT. T is not changing for the same time, and H2 equal to twice I whole square RT. So it will be 4 I square RT times. Obviously, it will be option B, 4 times. Option B, 4 times. Clear? Now going for the next one, that is A. Keeping the resistance and time as constant for a conductor. What are the things constant? Resistance constant, time constant. Keeping the resistance and the as constant and time constant of a conductor, if current through the conductor is twice of its initial value, the heat through the conductor. Just I had done two questions. See, representations are different. First of all, they are not giving us the data regarding resistance and voltage. Second question, they are giving data the resistance and voltage. So obviously, just I had done. That is that question is copied from test paper. So that's why there is a repetition. Okay. So question number 8 also the same option. Here option will be B. Here the options are twice, 4 times, 6 times, 8 times. So option will be B. Next one. Question number 9 we are going for. If for a good conductor, we are increasing temperature. Good conductor, we are increasing temperature. Then resistivity will be. We know what will be, what will be the change of the resistivity. It will increase, decrease, same or no change. See, resistivity something which is just or nearly equal to resistance. That much knowledge we are having. But resistance for a conductor is same, but resistivity depends on the material. So, we know if it is a good conductor, resistivity depends on temperature. So, if I rises the temperature, resistivity also rises if and only if. Remember, resistivity rises if and only if it is a good conductor. So, options are increased, decrease, same, first increase, then decrease. Obviously, the option A, increase. Achha, first increase, then decrease, that will be not. Same, no, that will be an incorrect answer, not correct, and decrease the no chance. Next one, question number 10. Which one of the following does not follow Ohm's law? See, when I discuss Ohm's law, I told you few things. That is, ohmic conductor, non-ohmic conductor. Ohmic conductor means which follow Ohm's law. Non-ohmic conductor, which doesn't follow Ohm's law. Doesn't follow Ohm's law means what? Doesn't follow Ohm's law means where V equal to IR principle, V equal to IR principle will not follow. Where V equal to IR principle will not follow. So, which will not follow? Silver, good conductor. Copper, good conductor. Aluminium, good conductor. Silicon. Silicon is a semiconductor. Means they are a partial conductor of electron. Clear? So that will not follow Ohm's law. So for question number 10, option will be D. Question number 10, option will be D. Clear? Now coming for the next question. By using Fleming's left hand rule. Listen. By using Fleming's left hand rule, which one of the following has made? Electric iron, generator, electric motor and heater. What we know, electric iron, Joule's law of heating. Generator, Fleming's right hand rule. Electric motor, just like Barlow's wheel. And Barlow's wheel, just I discussed, that is depends on Fleming's left hand rule. And heater also, the last option is depends on Joule's law of heating. So, my option will be C. So, question number 11 will be option C. Question number 11 will be option C. So, that's all about MCQ for this class. Now, I am going for the next revision classes. So, next is, two MCQ remaining. Next MCQ is, the filament of electric bulb. We know electric bulb, there is a filament like this. So this, the filament of an electric bulb made by mica, nichrome, tungsten, fire clay. Tungsten will be the answer. Option C, tungsten. And heater is made by nichrome. Mica is a glossy substance that will not make fire clay. It's a bad conductor. So that will not use. Clear. So the 12th MCQ we had done in this class. Right now I am going for few important numericals. The numericals what we had already done, that is also important. Those are also important because this chapter is very important. All the chapters are important, but this chapter is a little bit tricky, as I told you earlier. So let's go for the numericals. Numericals also you have to copy from here, please. So let's go. What length of the copper wire of specific resistance 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter and radius 1 millimeter is required so that its resistance is 1 ohm. Clear? So what are the thing given? What length of the copper wire? So what should be the length of the copper wire of specific resistance given? So what are the things given? This is question number 13. So given what? Copy now. Huh? Given rho equal to 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter. Clear? Rho equal to 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter given. Achha. This is what? Specific resistance or resistivity, whatever you want to call it. Radius of the conductor given 1 millimeter means small r. Radius equal to 1 millimeter. Clear? Other thing given what? Resistance of the conductor. R given, that is 1 ohm. I need to find out L. I don't know. Achha. Conductor means something cylindrical. So this is a cylindrical conductor. Something cylindrical. This is a cylindrical conductor. Radius of here. This R given. This R provided us this R. Okay. So first I need to calculate this circumference area. Why? Because we know according to that resistance and resistivity relation, that is R equal to rho L by A. So here L I need to find out. R given, so if it is a circle, so R given, so area pi r square, we know that. So first let's calculate pi r square. Rho given, capital R given, I can easily calculate L. So let's going for that. I'm just rubbing it. You copy it now, right? So A equal to area equal to A equal to pi r square. Achha. R is what? R is 1 millimeter here. So first I need to convert in SI unit. So 1 millimeter meter, decimeter, centimeter, millimeter means divided by 1000. 1 by 1000 meter. So keep it like that. So it is actually 10 to the power minus 3 meter. So put it here. Pi equal to what we know? Pi equal to 3.14. So 3.14 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. One thing done. Now simple thing. So R equal to rho L by A. L equal to R A by rho. R A by rho. L equal to R A by rho. So R equal to 1 ohm into 3.14 into 10 to the power minus, yes, one mistake I had done, that is R square, means R is this one, it will be square. So 10 to the power minus 3 whole square, keep, make it square, 10 to the power minus 3 whole square, copy down. So 3.14 into 10 to the power minus 3 whole square divided by the specific resistance given. Specific resistance given 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 8. So 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 8. Now simple, do the calculation. Let's go in for the calculation. So here 10 to the power minus 3 into 2 means square. This is 3.14 into 10 to the power minus 6. Whole divided by 1.7 into 10 to the power minus by 1.7, it will be coming upstairs, so it will be 10 to the power minus 8 will be plus 8, so plus 2 here, so plus 2, so 3.14 by 1.7, that is 3140 by 17 into 10 to the power, sorry, this 0 will become here. So 314 by 170, 10 to the power 2. Do the division. So if I do the division, that is 314 170, so it is first time it is coming with 170, means 17 is 34 there. 34 that will be not counted. So 17 into 170 will be first. So if it is 174.0, another 0 will be come this side. If another 0 is coming this side, oh, here to 1 means it will be 1 is coming here, so 1. So 0 is coming outside, so 8, 17, 8's are 0, 6, 3, 1, so remaining is, so nearly about equal to nearly 1.8 into 10 to the power 2 meter. So this is the answer, 1.8 into 10 to the power 2 meter. Clear? Now going for the next part of this revision class.